The blood moons. The tetrad of blood moons coming up 2014, 2015. April 15th, first one. What does that mean? What does it mean? Plus the two solar eclipses coming up within that time frame. Never before 2,000 years has that happened, the last 2,000 years. I've said that April 15th is the crucial day. As far as dates go, March 10th, could be the 8th, as early as the 8th, World War III started. World War III, the double three, the Malaysian plane that disappeared. 307, flight three, the three, double trident, symbol on its, on the plane. The trident standing for three, World War III. Symbology of World War III is the trident. April 4th was what I would say the heavy blitzkrieg. There was one earlier on March 10th, but it was somewhat less eventful. The one on April 4th was extremely eventful. On subtle levels we're talking about, the levels where stuff actually is going on, you know, not the stuff where we're looking at the sports or the news or the programs or, you know, lost in our day-to-day stuff, but what's actually going on, what actually took place on April 4th was that our real estate lady who's negotiating with God to purchase our home from God so that we can bring it here and she'll set it up somewhere and we can vacation there if we get, and she promised it to us, promised us that, so of course we can believe her, right? And she finally said on April 4th, she said, you know what, I've broken off negotiations with God. God is you cannot do business with God, he's a lunatic. You know how the men are, stubborn, principled, unbending, unyielding, sticking to their principles and their will and all this crazy stuff. How can he, why can't he just compromise a little bit? Come on. So she said, I can't do it. I can't. I've ended negotiations. And she says, you know what? Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Because we now have the technology for you to be happy. We now have all this high technology for you to be happy. All these images now, we can send images all over the place. So you don't need your home. I don't need to buy it, purchase it from God. I had the money. I made a great offer. Everything was fine. It's just that God is crazy. So I stopped negotiations, which means full steam ahead on educating you how to value images as your reality. April 4th. And since that time, what happened was the attitude of the world hardened. What I found out was the hard turn to the left, which is what that Malaysian plane did it not? Hard turn to the left, to the west, but the left would be their left, pilots flying the plane from Kuala Lumpur to towards Beijing. Hard turn, immediate hard turn to the left. That's what happened April 4th, hard turn to the left, real hard. And what I experienced was the attitudes of those who are imagine themselves to be exemplars of learning how to love images and making that their new home, their superior home, of course, way superior to reality. They got their marching orders and their stance suddenly hardened. Hard left stance is what happened April 4th. I've been reeling from that ever since, April 7th now. Yesterday was one of the toughest days of my life. I didn't know if I'd be able to come out of it. Thank God the Holy Spirit answered my prayers and brought me from petrified fear to divine laughter in a day, one day, miracle of miracles. So, April 15th, there's so going to be something at that time also. That's also very important that we literally be in good humor by that time. Be in good humor by that time. Have to be in good humor by that time. So, how are we going to get there? Well, the Holy Spirit got me from petrified fear to good humor in a day's time. So, it's not impossible. It is not impossible. I've got my battle helmet on right now. Yeah. Because here comes World War III. You see, here comes World War III. Three spaces, and we have to be beyond that. We have to be beyond that. We have to be beyond it. There's still a lot of fear inside. Fear hit me hard. So, how do we get beyond it? First, let's realize we have to get beyond it. By the 15th, how many days is that? 8 days. Well, the Holy Spirit can get me from this incredibly disturbed, frightened state to one of great release and divine laughter and just buoyant, buoyant. Everybody said to me, said, "Wow, you're happy today." It's like, "Huh? Who's this?" I just overflowing with good spirit and good cheer and good humor today. Just totally opposite yesterday. Now, it's not manic depression. It is the Holy Spirit giving me the right focus. That's it. It's the right focus. You need to be aligned with the right focus. Hence, we have this studio setup of alignment. And our alignment has to go up to the light. Hence, this white hat symbolizing the light coming down upon us, the pure light of great good humor. We need to be able to laugh at what we have done to ourselves and get a humorous perspective on it, truly. And what have we done? The question is, we've pranked ourselves. We played a prank on ourselves. That's all we've done. And once we start being able to laugh with God about it, then it just, the whole thing lightens up for us in the most amazing way. We say, "Hey God, I played a prank on myself." Can you prank the prank, please, for me? I need to have the prank pranked, because I've got this painting, I think it's real valuable. And it's all decaying and falling apart and crumbling and cracking and oxidizing but I'm afraid to let go of it. Can you find a way to prank the prank that, I'm playing a prank on myself. Play a prank on the prank, please. Please, play a prank on the prank. This is our prayer. This is our prayer. This is our prayer. This is our prayer. This is my prayer for everyone is to have the prank pranked. Now, of course, when you're playing a prank, you realize that you're laughing. Of course, we haven't been laughing very much at this prank we played on ourselves. So, what we need is God to prank the prank. It's God's prank on the prank. That's the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is God's prank on the prank. You see? And so the Holy Spirit needs to bring us to laughter. Real laughter at ourselves. We have to be able to laugh at ourselves and how silly that we pranked ourselves by imagining these characters coming to purchase our home from us and thinking we could sell it to these imaginary projections, characters, and thinking that we sold our home, we don't own it anymore. Someone else owns it. We need to worship them. Can I please go home? What can I do for you that I can go home? And we think we're entrapped by them. We're in prison. They think our will is in prison. No. Our will can never be bound. Our will can never be divided. It's indivisible. So, but we played this joke, a prank. It's a prank we played on ourselves. Elaborate prank. A real whopper. Just imagine what kind of prank the Son of God would play upon itself. Well, this is it. This is it. This is it. Yeah. And so we are entering the phase, April 15th, I believe, will be the phase where we feel that we either can laugh at the whole thing and decide to go along with the prank of the prank on the prank, or we're going to stay with the prank and desperately try to learn how to love images as greater love than we have of reality of our home of God. A greater love. We're going to have to try to learn how to love images more than we love God. And you can imagine this is going to be quite an interesting classroom at that time. Quite an interesting classroom for sure. Need to prank that prank for sure, right? it's really going to be quite a... We're going to be pranking ourselves quite a bit then. And of course, the students who are kind of unruly, they're going to be dealt with, put in a separate special ed situation. Special ed. Now, I know what's to come, basically, because I was heavily pressured to help out the prank that we're playing on ourselves. And you know, we all love a good prank, right? So I said, that's kind of interesting, that's kind of funny. But eventually I realized, you know, no, that's I'm tired of believing that I'm apart from my will. I'm tired of believing I'm apart from my home, apart from my safety, security, happiness, my creations, my creator. I'm tired of all that, you know. It's time to go home. So it's time to prank the prank, which is fun. It's fun. It should be fun. I can tell you what the others, all sorts of various, you know, it's massively complex, this whole learning process that the goddess is going through. The goddess's teacher, she's taken off her real estate hat now, trying to buy reality from God for us, promising, oh, don't worry, I can buy that for you. And now she's put on the teacher's hat, and now she's going to teach us all how to love symbols, images more than reality, symbols, how to love symbols more than reality. And so that's going to be a very, very wild classroom for sure. And I was trained to be a student teacher kind of thing, and to use these images of great saints, to use imagery of the most beautiful nature, the most beautiful special effects, the most beautiful music, and to blend everything together through video, through graphics, through everything, into these stunningly beautiful, spiritually seductive presentations where people would feel that the goddess is here and she's dwelling on a beautiful island here in the world, and she's here to bless us, and we're not quite ready for her yet, but her spirit is here, she's here, and she's blessing this endeavor to learn how to love symbols more than God. And it was a whole thing of around this goddess image, persona, maybe a person in the world actually who's going to play that role. And she will be dressed in the most incredible clothes, spiritual clothing. She'll seem like the most amazing, amazing spiritual being imaginable, because it's the work of the artists to frame her, you know, to frame her. Hence this frame I'm talking about. This is also symbolic. frame this goddess so everybody thinks this is the goddess herself. Symbology, the backdrops, the flowers, the colors, I mean, they're just on and on and on. The frame, the presentation, it will seem so slick and so beautiful. And people will be completely mesmerized by it. And of course, they'll say, well, you're not quite ready for her, to see her yet, but she's here in person on this planet, dwelling on some remote island. You don't exactly sure where it is, or you can't really get there. And meanwhile, all these top-notch artists are slaving away night and day to present her as this, the highest of the high, here to inspire us to accomplish this great learning task. So he's very slickly presented, for sure. So I wasted so many years of my life becoming a super expert at this, and even being able to manage the whole thing, being a supervisor of it, understanding the entirety of how to present images in symbols in the most beautiful way possible, extraordinary stuff. But then I said, there's something wrong with all of this. I start digging. I said, I don't think I'm gonna do this. There's something very uneasy about this, It seems like this is going to be used to mislead people. And so back away. No. Holy Spirit, what's going on? It seems like it's the greatest honor imaginable to present this great motivator to the world. But what is she motivating us towards? Learning to love symbols more than reality? Is that possible? What kind of trouble is that going to get us in, is the question. We're still pranking ourselves big time. So we need to prank the prank. We need to prank the prank. Holy Spirit needs to, actually. It's the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit had me get this. I found this today, this background. And I found this hat today. In fact, I have a whole bunch of these hats. Maybe we can all wear them. A whole stack of hats. Free. Everything was free. He was at the dump. Found all this stuff. So he said, the Holy Spirit said, do this. And I said, huh? Why? What's going on? Yeah. Said, okay. And look at this. It's pretty interesting. Pranking the prank. This is the beginning of pranking the prank. Pranking the prank. We love to play a prank on ourselves. So let's have the Holy Spirit play a prank on our prank. We can appreciate that. You see, we're down with that. We're cool with that. That's what's up. Because, we're not quite ready to let go of this prank. So if we have a prank, pranking the prank, it's still a kind of a prank. So we're happy about that. We're happy about it. So I'm waiting to see what kind of prank the Holy Spirit's going to play. Can't wait. Fantastic. It will have something. Maybe I can play a little role in that prank, pranking the prank. You need to be able to laugh at the whole thing, seriously. You need to seriously laugh at the whole thing, because if you don't, you're going to take it seriously. And that's trouble. That's trouble. Don't take the goddess seriously. Don't take her seriously, you see, or else you're going to be in big trouble for sure. Because once you hook into that motivation at a deep level and you're totally into it, and you think this is God, I mean, this is greater, this is someone's greater than God, I mean, this is someone's teaching us to be greater than God, and she's here, just imagine how far down the rabbit hole you're going to go. Just imagine that. Or don't imagine it. Don't imagine it. Laugh about it, because we're not going to do that. Or a better rabbit hole. Learning to accept the vision of oneness, though, the image of ever-fresh, the ever-fresh image, the ever-fresh symbol, the symbol that reminds us of reality. But there's more to it than that. There is this prank. God is pranking the prank for us. And the Holy Spirit's a genius. The Holy Spirit's a genius. Let's make no mistake about it. If there's anything you're going to be in awe of, it's the Holy Spirit. And it's genius. It brings me to tears. It really does. It really does. When I see it, all I can do is laugh. It's just a total genius. And you really realize, wow, that's us. That's who we are. And we've just been pranking ourselves. We think we sold our soul. We think we sold our identity to this real estate lady. We think we sold reality to the real estate lady. We think we can't go back there. And we say, we want to go back. She says, well, God won't release the deed to me. You know, it's in escrow. And I almost got it for you. Okay, just wait a little longer. Yeah, but I'm going to die. She says, well, that's God's fault. He's dragging his heels. You know, he just won't release the property to me. We're just pranking ourselves with this. So we are the genius, really. The Holy Spirit represents our true genius. It represents it, and it will prank the prank. It will prank the prank. I don't know how, but it's already starting out pretty well here. I told you, here comes the cat. I said, the cat, don't bother me with this video. Maybe he's saying, that's enough. That's enough. Prank the prank. Maybe it is enough. So, we will start. We will see what the Holy Spirit will do. He's already done something here. I don't know what it's doing. It's pranking the prank. Have to be able to laugh with the laughter of recognition. Like, this is just a prank. I'm just pranking myself. the goddess is here. Okay. Don't take it seriously. What I mean is be seriously humored by it. Seriously humored. Serious laughter, if we can use that term. What's that? That's the opposite of an oxymoron. So I was in fabulous good humor today, best ever. Holy Spirit somehow activated my humor. I was like Jim Carrey plus. Jim Carrey plus. Ridiculous. I'm afraid of it because if people see me like that, they say, who are you? What are you? You gone crazy? That's not you. You're this like, depressed person. I said, well, occasionally this other side of me bubbles to the surface. What can I do? But it's too funny. It's like a continuity problem. Like people go, well, who's this? Well, you're possessed. You must be possessed. What's possessing you? I'm possessed by the spirit of good humor. What's wrong with that? Maybe I'm the good humor man now. Got the ice cream hat on or something. Maybe that's it. Good humor, man. Yeah. So, if we can realize, like, laugh the situation away, really, then, that will liberate us. It'll actually liberate us. We say, here she comes. Okay. And what do we say? Goddess, I'm sorry, you can't afford me. You cannot afford me. I'm sorry, goddess. You cannot keep me in a style that I'm accustomed to. You can't afford me. I'm accustomed to a certain lifestyle. And you can't keep me in my lifestyle. There's no deal. It's not fair to me. And she says, what do you mean? Well, why? I can afford you. She says, no, you can't, because my lifestyle is perfect. See? God created me perfect. I require a perfect lifestyle. I require everything to be perfect. You can't do that for me. He says, well, you know, I can't do that for you, but can't you help me? I said, no, I'm sorry, it's not fair to me. I'm not able to accommodate you. You just can't afford me. That's how it is. Sorry, but I cannot change my lifestyle. It's unchangeable. My lifestyle is unchangeable, so you can't afford me. Goddess, you cannot afford me. Gotta say it. Gotta be honest. Gotta be straightforward. Hey, Goddess, you cannot afford me. That is the truth. So you have to look elsewhere. Maybe some people will say that you can afford them. They're affordable. All right, you can purchase them. Can't purchase me. I require perfection. I require absolute perfection. Nothing but perfection, eternally. I require eternal perfection. You don't have that coin. You got a symbol of it. You think you do. Symbol. But even that symbol is crumbling. And even the eyes that you give me to see the symbol are crumbling. You see? And that's not perfection. So, Goddess, you can't afford me. Goddess, you cannot afford me. Essential to be able to say that. It's essential to be able to say that in good humor, to be bubbling over with good humor. You know, I mean real good humor. You know it when you got it. It's unbelievable. You know, your Jim Carrey on spiritual steroids, okay? Our spirit is an infinitely inventive and genius, total genius, and when it turns to real good humor of, hey, I'm being liberated, then you become just amazingly humorous and funny. It's just like a flow, stream of consciousness, funny. But it's not the stale kind of humor of the ego. You know, it's bubbling over, it's overflowingness. It's overflowingness. So it all starts with, I'm sorry, Goddess. You can't afford me. But Red, you know, don't leave me. Sorry, my dear. I really don't give a damn. Yeah, we need more red butlers in the world, right? There's a lot of Scarlet O'Hara's attitude. You can't leave me. I gotta learn how to love symbols more. You gotta be a symbol to me, and I gotta learn to love you. And Red says, no, I'm not a symbol. I was just a prank. I was playing on myself. And now I'm pranking the prank. So, frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn. You can't afford me. You cannot afford me. Okay? So we all gotta have a little red butler in us, you know? It's like, this is how it is. You can't afford me. Sorry, but you can't afford me. And accept it. Accept it. Because that's the truth. That is the truth. We're just pranking ourselves. Will we ever be satisfied with this prank? Of this, continuing this prank on ourselves? Is that what we really want? Because that's what we got right now. The answer is no. We'll never be satisfied with that. Imagining that we have been sold ourselves into slavery. Imagining that we have something more valuable than reality, and yet it's a painting on canvas, and it's disintegrating, and we're telling ourselves, oh my God, look at this canvas, it's disintegrating, that's even better. This is even better, my God. I thought I had something better, reality, which I did, the painting, but now I've got something that's 10 times better than even the painting. It's dying. You know, how can we be satisfied with that forever? Can we dwell in this prank forever, is the question. And obviously, you know, self-evidently the answer, which is no. No, 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 we cannot. So we have to prank the prank. The Holy Spirit has to prank the prank. So who knows what I'll do. Maybe I'll start doing that, pranking the prank. We have to prank the goddess before she catches our hearts, you know, catches our attention. She can't, don't let her catch your attention. Because she's going to turn you into stone. You know, she's going to turn you into the stone of believing that you can learn to love symbols more than you can learn that more than you love God. That you can learn to love symbols. That you can learn to love death, actually, more than you love God. More than you love life. That's what the goddess will tell you. She's here to help you on the final step, the final frontier. You're going to learn to love death more than you love life. And she's going to inspire you to that, you see. So, maybe we have to be spiritual comedians at this point. It's not a joke, but we need to turn it into a joke. You know, it's like that. I mean, the idea of trying to learn to love death more than life, that's not a joke. That's not funny. When you're trying to do it, it's terrifying. I just feel the fear, you know, that's in the world right now. Holy cow. It's horrible. And if you're not able to get out of it, it's going to grip you. And in order to try to escape it, you're going to go full blast into this agenda. A teacher lady is going to try to tell you she can teach you that. And she's got all her teachers lined up everywhere, you know, ready to teach, help you learn this lesson. So, yeah, I felt the full grip of it on me, and I was able to shake it off to some point. Then the good humor arises, and we can help others, you know, laugh it off. We need to just laugh it off. Say, ah, ha, 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 I'm pranking myself. I now I see. This is just an image that I'm projecting that's talking to me, you know, is trying to con me, you know, I'm just pranking myself. And then the humor comes up and you laugh and say, oh, that's funny. Okay, all right. Enough of that. Let's prank the prank and let's return home. You know, let's put the painting down, the painting of death down. You know, the dying painting of death. Let's put it down. And let's get the prank pranked, and the Holy Spirit will do it for sure. You call upon the Holy Spirit to prank the prank for you. Really call upon. I call upon it right now. Call upon it, Holy Spirit. Prank the prank. We call upon you, really. The whole world calls upon you to prank the prank, because we're playing a really, you know, a really nasty prank on ourselves now. And it's time to prank the prank for sure. For sure. Thank you. Thank you. In Jesus' name, in the name of God, in our name, which is Jesus, we are. The sonship is one. The sonship is one. The sonship is one. We all of us are Jesus. All of us are the Son of God. That's our identity. So, in the name of our own name, we can use Jesus if you want to. We can use any name you want, but the idea is we're all one. We're all one name. The name of God is our name. And so we pray in the name of, in our name of our undivisible will, that Holy Holy Spirit, let this be so. Holy Spirit, prank the prank. Prank the prank. Prank the prank. Okay. Very great. Very great. I don't know. This could be a lot of fun. I hope so. It should be. All right. Very great. That's it for this one.